Then we transferred to the Arnold building and again grew up to around 200 people in size. And the Lord blessed us, and we had school going and the church going. And then the fire came at my 40th birthday. And at that point, the fire took out the offices and part of the school, and yet we continued on, we pressed on, we cleaned it all up, we renovated it, and made it beautiful again.
See, we've been through a fire, we've been through floods, we've been through three churches that we've actually rebuilt.
And then the state came in and said they wanted that building because it was all nice. And so they moved us out, and we were able to come to this location, and we purchased this location instead of renting for $400 a month like before.
We want to continue this, and we're only going to do it in the love of Christ if we keep ourselves in that. If we continue to have the same mercies and judgments that he led with as he did with his disciples, same compassions, even when they were upset and indifferent and concerned and going through hardships, even when they were angry. We do that in our homes, and we need to look at the church as a home and a place where we're going to spend eternity together.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that's within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfieth thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles. Behold, I send an angel before thee to keep thee in all thy way, and to bring thee into the place which I have prepared. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation, there shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways.
Probably one of my favorite memories, believe it or not, are all the work days when you see everybody together and how they get along and how they help each other, young and old, all doing it together.
There's a peace I've come to know, though my heart and flesh may fail. There's an anchor for my soul, I can say it is well. Jesus has overcome, and the grave is overwhelmed. The victory is won. Darkness breaks to light, and the shadows disappear, and my faith shall be my eyes. Jesus has overcome, and the grave is overwhelmed. Is risen.
You know, this church has been in existence for longer than I've been alive. You know, and it's an amazing thing to think about all the men and women that have passed through this church throughout the years, or all the students that have graduated through the school, and how they can say they've been affected in a positive way by the men and women in this ministry. You know, what a wonderful heritage the Lord has blessed us with. You know, and then I think about all the trials and the tribulations that we've passed through as a church, and those difficult, hard times, and how, you know, at times we didn't think we were going to make it. You know, it's only because of the loving, sacrificial love between the brothers and sisters being willing to work and give of themselves throughout the years that we still exist. And it's only been the gracious hand of the Lord upon this ministry, blessing it and pushing it forward throughout the years, that we have survived. You know, it's a wonderful work we have here. I hope we never take it for granted. And I hope the Lord blesses us with another 30 years if He tarries. But one thing's for certain, this has always been His work. This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes.
So one of the things I really like about this church is it seems like we all just get along. So
yeah, because you would... Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead, brother.
Oh, you're fine.
So and then we would that, just get on the... Oh, I'm, did I cut you off again? Oh, I'm sorry, man.
You're
sorry.
Fine. You're fine.
And then so we would get on the...
One of the things I really love about the church is just that we're all just such a close family. Mm. It just seems like, you know, brothers and sisters all coming together. No matter what we do, it just seems like we're a close-knit family. And
I know, it's great,
with,
isn't it?
With, I guess I wasn't really, I'm not that close a family, but...
Something a little too close.
I guess, yeah.
That was great.
All right, I don't get it. But basically, you want to know how long they've been making us come here? Is that what he's after?
I think that's what he's
after. Okay, well...
I like the comfortable pews. Pastor keeps you awake, won't go to sleep listening to him. It's not like a lot of churches where it's really boring.
Today we're going to be talking about Melchizedek. So open your Bibles to Hebrews chapter 5.
So one of the things I really, holy cow, like about this church is this. Can we do this inside? I forgot my coat.
I think one of the toughest times that I can remember was... The roof. When I came back and started teaching here, it was getting really, really bad. It was deteriorating. It was leaking very badly. Yeah, those were the years of the flood.
I'm Scott, I'll be weatherman. If you look, you can see coming out of the northwest, we have a cold front blowing in. It's going to cause lake effect snow showers coming directly right down into Norton, Ohio. Why it comes right from the over us, I don't know. Could be a sign.
This is what I looked like when I came to the church.
And this is what it looks like 28 years later.
Time is on my side. Yes, it is. Time. I think my favorite thing about the church is how Pastor Tim is so real, and he comes straight from the King James Bible, and he's not all easy like all these other churches.
You know, Hametown Baptist Church has been around since 1980, I can't remember. Let's ask Jeff.
Well, one of the things I appreciate very much about the church and school since I've been here since I've been seven is the fact that I met my husband, Steve Weiss, here at the school and the church, and the prayer to keep us together after 15 years, because, you know, frankly, sometimes it's kind of like being married to a kid. So, I don't know. If you could keep praying, that would be great.